shifting your paradigm. Shifting your paradigm. The lady on the scene, Celine Salon. The salon, the Celine. The lady on the scene. You know what I mean? The lady on the scene, Celine Salon. Celine Salon. Celine Salon. Celine Salon. Celine Salon. The lady on the scene.
Hello and welcome to Celine Salon, all the way from a tiny little front room in the heart of Soho. And oh my word, I am so lucky to have finally got to the point that we've all been wishing for a collaboration across the seas. And the first country we have chosen is Celine Salon presents South Africa. But the first thing I want to say is hello to everyone that's watching in South Africa and in the UK. And the one thing we do ask before we continue is for all of you to press the subscribe button. It costs nothing, but it helps raise awareness and momentum and keeping the message and the show of Celine Salon continuously going.
Celine Salon, Celine Salon, Celine Salon, the lady on the scene.
So, without, we can do a London show, but I do need a bloody good co-host. And who perfect that, who also has inspired us for a collaboration, but to introduce the beautiful and wonderfully talented Douglas Wilson.
Oh, thank you, Celine. It's just so lovely to be here. And it is an honour to be a part of the show and to be facilitating a creative collective in an international forum. Yes.
So I just want to sort of know how you came to be in London. What was the influence? And also, yeah, just tell me about your creativity in South Africa and then coming to London.
Yes. Well, I have a deep love for South Africa and Cape Town, but I've always had a deep love for London and the United Kingdom. And over the years, I've travelled between the two. And I didn't intend to stay as long as I did this time, but it's just been a very interesting era to be in London and to be witnessing all that's going on, good and bad.
So, you know, you've been writing and reciting your poetry for, I don't know, 3 years at the Salon now, about 4 years.
I think it's four years.
We met at the French House.
That's right, we did.
It was like meant to be, magnets are sort of like,
yes,
but can you just tell me, let's, before we go into, tell me about your background in South Africa and your writing.
Yes, well, in South Africa I was working as a freelance advertising copywriter.
Cheers.
Cheers, darling. But I've also done a lot of poetry shows. Mm-hmm. And stand-up poetry shows, produced them, been to the Grahamstown Arts Festival, performed in various venues across South Africa over the years. And I've kind of continued with that. But thank you so much for inviting me into Celine Salon, because it really helped me find a creative community and family.
Yeah. And I think it's lovely when we have people globally come on board.
Yes.
As I spoke to you earlier before we started filming, we're going to be collaborating with Malaysia, but this is the first big ever sort of over the seas, cross the seas collaboration.
It's so exciting, Celine, because also what I've witnessed in Celine Salon is you don't only just have the London regulars, you have so many people from so many parts of the world coming in and out, and there's this wonderful cross-cultural creative pollination. And I've really got behind what you're doing, and it's just been so amazing to see how it's evolved over the 4 years that I've been here.
Yeah, and you're actually in the process of a manuscript putting together your
own poem. I am.
So you kind of came with a few, you know, book of poems, and now you're sort of, I've seen as a host of the show and curator, your confidence just like flourish and like,
thank you.
Like blossomed, which is really beautiful to see.
A big part of that, Celine, is being around other creative people and bouncing off ideas and hearing people from different disciplines as well coming with such original work. It can only be inspirational.
And you know, I think with the lockdown we've kind of kept that torch burning. You know, there's no, you know, natural, it's really been quite inspiring to sort of not give up and go, Come on.
Yeah, I think it's a time where...
Let's roll our sleeves up and be troopers.
Yes, I think it's a time where you really have to search within yourself and figure out what's going on around you. But having a creative outlet is just so paramount, so definitely important, because it can really help you to channel feelings that you're going through in a constructive way.
Yes. Mm-hmm. So, without further ado...
Yes, my dear.
You have beautifully curated, you know, this is your curation of a salon. And obviously the people that you know from South Africa.
Yes.
Let's start with our first performer.
Yes. Well, before we get into that, I just also want to say, as a preface, thank you so much to all of the South African artists who have so generously given their work to Celine Salon.
Thank you.
And thank you for inviting me onto this platform with you to showcase some of the most amazing South African talent. And without further ado, I think we should introduce our first South African artist.
Okay. Over
to me. Well, the first person we're going to be introducing is Kate Normington. Kate is one of South Africa's leading actors, renowned for her performances on both stage and screen. Her self-deprecating wit and humour is legendary across the country and the world. And she's a master of satire, always delivering her keen societal observations with enviable comedic timing.
So without further ado, let's bring on Kate Normington.
Kate Normington.
Yay! Woohoo! Woo!
Thank you so much. I'm so glad to be here at the Miladies Awards, practically brand new before you're ready to receive the Toby Kushlik Award for Most Tenacious Oldcomer. You know, I have a feeling Toby is with us tonight and is enjoying herself enormously.
She's behind you!
No, she isn't.
She is!
No, she isn't! Naughty little plants. Seriously, I've been so fortunate through the years with all the talented folk I've worked with. It all started way back when P.T. Turin gave me my first big break in the year. There's no need to go into all of that now. Suffice it to say that you won't believe this, but, well, a lot of people wouldn't work with me when I came out of rehab, when I came off the health farm. Wouldn't touch me with a 10-foot bloody barge pole, would they? But one person touched me with her barge pole. Darling, you know who you are. Thank you for trusting me with that small yet pivotal role in your sumptuous pantomime, Mother Goose. Modesty aside, I don't think it's every actress who can transform herself nightly into a golden egg and yet still remain sunny side up. Sweetie. I hope I didn't. Oh, fuck, have I gone overtime? Yes, well, now it's my great pleasure to encourage the future of our noble profession by introducing the Saffron Mortimer Award for the most promising newcomer of 2020. She's done so well over the last year in Greece, Rocky, Hair, Annie, Buddy, Jesus Christ Superstar 3, The Revenge, and many other adolescent musical fantasies, thanks to the preference of theatrical audiences for that sort of entertainment. She hasn't had to resort to the old subterfuge of facelifts or eye tucks, jawline liposuction that goes a little wrong and leaves one half of your face sagging slightly more than the other, which drives you to drink a bit more than usual, so you always end up looking like shit anyway. Can't remember lines, fail to turn up for the very few auditions your disinterested agent sends you up for, become reclusive and lose all faith in a world that has no respect for the lines that life put on your face. God damn it, not you. You didn't ask for them. They just arrived and now you're... Oh, God damn it, I haven't finished. So... Well done, Kimberly Lee. Just one last thing, darlings. Just as we don't choose our family, nor do we choose this profession. No, it chooses us. It seduces us and leaves us with a small virus we can never be rid of, ever, even when we're old. I hope you'll remember that, Kimberly Lee. I really hope you do. Well, 20 miles to London and still no sign of Dick. Good night.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. If that's just a first taster, I don't know what else you have up your sleeve.
How is that delivery? And I love the fact that she won the award.
Yes. And what she did with the award.
Darling, you deserve an Oscar.
I think, darling, we'll definitely get the Drama Queen Award after this.
A toast to Kate. Thank you, darling.
It's South African
amazing,
wine.
Amazing, amazing.
Sorry, loves. But I do like South African wine. Wow, well done, Kate Normington. And, so, we're going to move on to our next performer.
Oh, it gives me great pleasure, Celine, to introduce Christine Weir. Oh. Christine Weir is a legend. She's a founding member of Not the Midnight Mass, which has huge critical acclaim across South Africa and globally. It's transcendent and highly successful. It's actually an acapella group.
Whoa, I love acapella.
She's also a prolific actor, singer, songwriter, vocal coach. She's in fact written a book about vocal coaching. And her
acapella
rich...
Acapella's
hard. Oh, it is. It is.
You've got to be quite brave. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, you've got to know your instrument.
Yes, it is an instrument.
You know, darling. And her rich, velvety mezzo-soprano is unmistakable, as are her Celtic-themed pop rock songs. And I think we're going to be treated to one of those right now.
So, please, watch and enjoy Christine Weir.
I could know your sweet face and knew. questions that burn. Prayers lie unanswered. Stories that shape. Things that we are from a barren white sun to a tumbling planet. The space that's between us grows distant and far.
My word, Douglas. Whoa!
Emotion. I'm just seeing cosmos and connecting to spirit and gentleness and beauty. Thank you, Christine.
And just have Celtic in there as
bloody hell. No, it's subtle but beautiful. Thank you, Christine. Absolutely amazing. And she has a new video coming out soon.
Oh, great.
And another little tidbit, by the way.
Yes.
Christine has just moved to London.
Whoa. Christine, come on, up you get.
So watch out, London.
And please, everyone, just so you know, we've got a lovely little comments section. So just drop a little note. Let us know how you feel. Support the artists that are here tonight from South Africa coming to London. Our goal is to get a live show to travel from London to South Africa.
Oh, yes.
So come on, bring it on. I want to see lovely comments. And also there's loads of lovely links, just so you know, where you can find all the artists.
Yes, absolutely. So I think we're moving on to...
Yeah, moving on swiftly.
On to our third doyen of drama. And her name is Megan Choritz. Megan is an enigmatic and captivating South African actor, improviser, playwright, author, and would you know it, tarot card reader. Or is it tarot?
Tarot.
I think it's tarot.
After this, babe.
I think we need another sip of wine, darling.
Carrot reader, if you
want to. Here's to tarot, darling. Anyway, she has a real passion for the South African creative arts community, like really involved. And she's equally at home with comedy as with more serious poignant pieces.
Okay.
And what she's going to give us tonight is a very beautiful story that she wrote herself.
And this is Megan Choritz.
Go, Megan.
The sound of ice. They say you can only see us from space. From there we are tiny flicker pinpricks, a join the dots circle of light bobbing on a dark sea. Like looking back up at the darkest corner of the sky where there is only a circle of stars. You would need to go to space to know we exist. I wake up to the sounds I know. There is the lonely yawning of the big ice, a creak and scream. There is the huge continuous slam of ocean against that wall of ice. Closer. I know that Ma's hands are pulling the rope, and I can hear her arms brush up against her skirt and apron. Shook, shuck, shook, shuck, shook, shuck. Every day the rope is pulled. Sometimes the wooden bucket attached to the rope has handwritten notes of greeting, bits of precious chocolate or scraps of fabric for sewing, messages from the other lighters. Women like sharing small gifts. And of course, there is our daily block of ice. We are known as the lighters. In our circle, there are 167 tiny boats, each with their own mother and daughter crew. We light a circle of protection for the iceberg. We defend it with our lights. We protect this valuable resource of pure water from thieves and pirates who might stumble upon us. You would say, how could we do anything? Ma says we're nothing more than an early warning system. They don't mind losing us, but we are safe here. The waves slap against wood. I peep out. It is dark. We sleep in the day and wake and watch at night. Let them know by radio if we see anything strange. Ma says my 13-year-old body is typical. I need sleep, hours of it. Ma says, lucky we out here with all the time in the world. Lucky for you. Ma, let's have tea. It's cold, Ma. I drag my coat off the floor, pull it under the bedclothes, grunting and struggling to put it on without letting any air in at the sides. Inside the coat pocket is my purple woolly hat, and I stick my head under the blankets to put it on. It smells, and I gag. When I burst through, Ma's laughing and my heart lights up. You've been warming yourself with farts again. She is chipping at the ice block and scraping the shards into a pot. Then straight onto the burner to boil for tea. Each boat gets a tiny block of the iceberg every day. It's the price it has to pay, poor thing, Ma says. I shuffle across the creaky wooden floor to the tiny cupboard and open the tin. Wrapped in oilcloth with tissue paper on the inside to keep them dry are ginger biscuits, one for each of us, one for every day of the month. There are two left. That means a delivery tomorrow. A month's supply of everything we need will be parachuted into the water near us, and we will haul it in. Also, once a month, the circle of boats is ruptured when the huge icebreaker comes to take a chunk of the iceberg to shore. The bell tinkles. A fish. Ma gets there first, opening the hatch in the floor and pulling a thinner thread this time until a silver fish pops up, gaping, bringing with it the cold and the salt on the air. I stand with a hammer and aim perfectly, crushing its head. I whisper thanks, like a prayer. I hate the moment of killing. Put on the TV and I'll fry it up, Ma. I clean the fish. Silver fish scales collect like extra nails on the ends of my fingers. The TV screen shows the sea, the camera moving in a circle and following the light. Over and over, forever and ever. The light makes the waves white, then grey, then black. It is the light and we are the lighters. Suddenly the beam passes across the surface of the iceberg and the TV screen goes completely white, no end or no beginning. Whenever I see that, I cannot breathe. It is the same cannot breathe feeling from before when we were not here, just a family, and the man, my father, has me in a chokehold, his body behind me and shoving. Ma! It's okay, Luce. It's okay. Here's a towel. I come back. I've pressed the scaling knife along my palm without noticing. Ma hands me the tea towel and I wrap my hand. She looks at me and I start breathing again. There is sorrow in her face. Deep and long, but the fear is gone. Before, at the woman's shelter, Ma had panicked. We had run with nothing when she had come home early from work and caught him up against me and me not breathing in a chokehold. She had struck out at him and we had run, even as he got to his feet threatening to kill us both. He will find us, she had cried, and then he will kill us over and over. The shelter knew where nobody would find us. We would be invisible, but we would be the lighters, like many before us and many more to come. That's where people like us go. The fish sizzles in the shallow pan. I sip tea, holding the mug one-handed and watching the liquid move in time with the waves outside. The ice groans and sighs. Ma runs her fingers along the tiny bookshelf. We'll have some new ones tomorrow, just think. She holds up a worn copy of Roald Dahl's BFG. Imagine the Queen of England. Imagine a giant, even a little one. And snozzcumbers, Ma, and whiz poppers. Imagine. I look at the TV. The beam moves across the waves, white, then grey, then black. We dip our ginger biscuits in the tea, just long enough for the edges to start crumbling away. And then we stuff them in our mouths and suck.
Douglas, I just love the diversity already of what's come onto the show this evening.
I know.
It's like being on a roller coaster. You know, what's next?
Blown away. The calibre of this.
And these are friends of, you know, not only obviously artists, but people that you've met along your journey.
Yeah. You know, I've spent some time working in the theatre, obviously through my performing, through my creative community in Cape Town.
Yes.
Inadvertently met a lot of these people or through friends, so it's just amazing they've all come on board. And I mean, what a beautiful piece, like so beautifully written, with such a wonderful underlying message.
Thank you so much, Megan.
Thank you, Megan. So beautiful.
Woo! Next up. Who's next up?
Oh, well, next up we have a little bohemian.
Okay.
A real little hippie bohemian. Her name is Sydney Scallon.
Okay.
Yes. So Sydney and I have actually known each other for quite a few decades. I won't reveal quite as, like, quite so long as we've known each other, but let's say a few decades.
A few decades.
She's absolutely amazing, absolutely creative in so many disciplines.
Yeah.
She's performed her emotive songs in bohemian coffee shops and venues over the years in both Durban and Cape Town, which are very creative cities in South Africa.
Yeah.
And she's also an accomplished guitarist, a singer-songwriter, and a prolific visual artist.
Oh, wow.
And she makes this amazing organic jewellery, which she designs and conceptualizes herself as well.
Bloody hell.
So, bloody hell. She really, really is involved in a lot of creative stuff. She's a powerhouse. And, this is a music video that she made a few years ago. And I think it's as relevant now as it was then.
Bring it on.
Sydney
Scallon. Yay!
Woohoo!
Woohoo!
Brain that gets its message through. I am shattering my cosmic clock. Hold it down, but it never stops. The point of my breaking break. The point of my no return. All I would see, silver fish, flying fish, white on a silver spoon.
Wow, Sydney Scallion, what a brilliant, brilliant act.
Oh my God.
And performer and writer and musician, the whole, everything's in there.
And didn't she just love the whole thing with Dorothy and the whole Wizard of Oz thing? Oh my God, I loved that. It was so transporting.
Really clever. So we'll be hoping to see more of her. And as I said, please add a comment. Tell us what you think. And don't forget to subscribe.
Subscribe.
Okay. So, what other little treats do you have up?
Well, yes, up my sleeve. Well, up my, the next person up my sleeve is Godfrey Johnson. Godfrey Johnson is amazing. He's a pianist extraordinaire, cabaret artist, actor, and singer-songwriter.
Wow.
And he's celebrated across South Africa for his award-winning shows and dynamic performances.
Okay.
Boy, has this guy got energy. I have seen him live.
Wow.
He's amazing.
We love energy.
He's recently received some national acclaim for his cabaret and album, The Shadow of Brel.
Oh, I see. Mm-hmm. So, without further ado, let us introduce Godfrey Johnson. Yay!
Yay!
Quite understand why I like it that way. I've got a pretty young thing walking by my side with not much to say and not much to hide, except hello, how are you? What a beautiful day. I'd like to get to know you, but I don't want you to stay. Beautiful lover in the world. myself with attitude and raise myself to another latitude. And then we'll see who's standing tall with my wings out on the
I do love the ivories and so beautifully played. And what, it was just so elegant, the whole thing. So I remember when you submitted the piece from him, I was just like, wow. So Godfrey, superb. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Godfrey.
And thank you to everyone who's contributed, actually. With, you know.
And that was an original song of his, by the way. Yeah.
Excellent.
So thank you, Godfrey.
Now, I've always wanted to add a bit of drag to Celine Salon. We've never had that opportunity. And to all the drag queens out there.
Oh, honey.
And drag kings, whoever. Please do get in touch because this is the first ever drag act we've had on Celine Salon.
And I think it's quite fitting that the first drag act on Celine Salon would be Lily Slapped Silly. What a drag name, baby. Rue! Rue! Well, Lily rose to fame as one half of the spectacular cabaret drag duo, okay. Mince, which was highly successful in South Africa. Since then, she's gone on to become one of the country's top drag artists. Okay. Absolute perfectionist. She also does stand-up comedy, is an MC, and a comedic auctioneer.
Whoa, that'd be brilliant.
I wonder what that entails. Yes.
Judy Garland's Botox preserve.
Yes. Hello, Lily Slap. And so basically she sprinkles her acerbic wit, style and glamour wherever her high heels tread.
Lily Slapped Silly.
most dramatic role of her life was her life in Mommy Dearest.
Yes?
We're ready for you, Miss Crawford.
You're very clever, don't you? Trying to sweep the poor little widow under the carpet? Well, think again.
There isn't a dirty cover-up in this entire business that I don't know about, and your hand is in every one of them, you reek of it!
I'm on the board of directors of this lousy company. I fought worse monsters than you for years in Hollywood. I know how to win the hard way.
Miss Crawford, we don't want any hard feelings.
You don't know what hard feelings are until I come out publicly against your product and you see how much you sell. Don't fuck with me, fellas! This ain't my first time at the rodeo. You forget the press I delivered to Pepsi was my power. I can use it any way I want. It's a sword. Cuts both ways. Thank you, gentlemen. Now let's get to work.
May as well have property of MGM tattooed on my backside.
Well, you're not a little shop girl anymore. Truth is, you're getting old.
I want you to leave Metro.
Leave Metro?
Your pictures, one after another, are losing money. Theater owners voted you box office poison.
It's the scripts, LB. Bad pictures, bad directors.
No, listen to me, LB. I have been begging you. Begging you for a good script.
You expect me to ignore my fans. They're life and death to me, baby. They're the ones who really made me.
Why are you screaming?
Because I'm damn mad!
If you're acting, you're wasting your time. If you're not, you're wasting mine.
I'm not acting!
I'm not acting!
Clean up this mess!
And the winner is Joan Crawford.
This is the bittersweet symphony.
Oh my God, I loved all of that. It was like sort of Joan Crawford, eat your heart out, like darling. Lip syncing. That's quite hard to do. Imagine sort of doing those kind of like Wallace and Gromit lips to like...
so amazing.
And well done, Lily. We love you. Please come to London. We
please
want you.
Please come to London and we'll get you signed up with RuPaul yet, darling.
So we've had everything. We've got like songs, we've got drag, we've got... So who's next, my love?
Well, this is a very interesting little segment, I think.
Okay.
Because this is Shannon Faree, and it's her
for real?
Day... Yes, for real.
For real.
For real.
Shannon, for real.
And it's her debut poetry offering.
I used to say debut. Do you not say debut?
Debut?
Debut and debut.
Yeah, debut.
What's that?
Anyway, I don't know. Anyway,
something about the boot, about wanting
But we figured it out now. It's debut.
Yes.
Yes, a second debut.
Okay.
But mainly, Shannon is known in South Africa as an actress. She's an acting coach and a singer. And she's a rockabilly pinup girl as well. Very glamorous. And she does makeup artistry.
Oh, wow.
And she's toured the world with a few... theatre productions as well. South African theatre productions. Mousetrap was one of those that she took around the world with
my
her.
My friend Georgie. Georgie Porgy was in Mousetrap. Mm. Yeah.
And wasn't there... Isn't there, like, the longest running show?
Yeah.
Mousetrap
like
in London?
The original cast... Set, like, kids are in it now.
Yeah.
It could have, like,
well, not right now because of COVID-19, but... we'll work our way out of that. She's also an outstanding musical artist.
Fantastic. Yes. So let's bring it on, Shannon Furry.
Woo!
Hi there, my name is Shannon Furry, and I am an actress and singer based in Cape Town. My brilliant friend Doug invited me to read some of my, I suppose you call them scribbles, for this amazing platform. And before I get started, I'm just going to have a little sip of my special tea. And by tea, I mean gin. And I dug around because a lot of my poetry or musings, I write on scraps of paper and then they end up becoming part of my Instagram posts. But I wanted to go way back to when it first began. So my cousin brought this beautiful book back from one of her trips in Italy. And my first poem in it is all the way from 1995. So, and that's when I still used to sign my poetry, which is really innocent and sweet, but yeah, a long time ago. And this book is pretty much full. I haven't written it in a while. So I'm going to go back to one of the first poems I wrote that I loved, that it was a time when I was reflecting on the world around me and just getting really into texture. So here we go. This is called Air. Cool and salty, misty and light, surrounds us in a cloud of wet kisses and cold hugs, embraces us with its transparency and tricks us with its existence. It whispers in our hair and settles on our nose. And then I followed that one up with coffee, which is my favorite thing in the whole world. Dark brown liquid with hot vapors evaporating into air. Strong taste of earthy beans laid in soil, until now in a cup we taste steamy liquid with fragrance of other places, rich with comfort and togetherness, warming from the inside out. What's so sweet is that I even drew some really basic drawings to accompany that one. This one was a little bit later down the line. This was in 2004. And this one is white, pure and clean, astringent and medical scent. White, beauty and clarity, showing up every single smudge. White, so clean and bright, I want to touch it. Feel it move and flow between my fingers, my dirty fingers with grime embedded under nails. I can't touch the white with these dirty hands, yet something stirs deeply within me, compels me to touch. So I touch and immediately feel released, but it's not enough. I have to tug at it, push it, crumple it between my sullied hands. When I'm done, I look and no longer see white. Only dirt from my skin that has soiled the beauty, my dirt, which has altered its purity. I look around and feel ashamed. Perhaps I should wash my hands. That one was definitely a metaphor for how I felt about my life, that things I got involved in perhaps altered it and made it less beautiful, took away its innocence, but really it was a reflection of how I was feeling at that time of my life, losing some of my own innocence. I'm going to end off on this last one. This was based on a painting I saw. Words aflame, the books burning again. Like a runaway thought, doors flung open, no holding back the tide. Deep, deep. Looking out beyond the ice, I hope it melts. The picture sits askew. My heart beats, lungs filling with air. I want to break free from myself, from this life. Freedom and flight. Here in this place, the books burning again. Thank you so much. And I hope you enjoyed it. And to all the artists out there, sending you so much love in this very difficult time where art is so necessary.
Well, yes, to a poetry debut. I mean, wow. If you're going to do it global.
Do it bloody global. Well done, my darling. Very, very impressed.
Mm-hmm.
And please, everyone, make a comment. Give support to all the artists that have contributed all their lovely work from South Africa. I'll tell you what, I feel touched, honoured, and I just see lovely days ahead with taking things
absolutely
on a bigger, wider scale.
And subscribe, because the more of us get involved and the more that we connect as a global community,
you know that,
the more magic can happen. Who knows what's going to happen?
Mm-hmm.
You know, you contact someone and then something happens and there's a gig here or there.
Yes.
Awesome.
Now, I don't know... This next act is like, what can I say?
I've heard he's a bit dodgy, darling. I've heard he's a bit
get
dodgy.
Get with the program.
I've heard he's a bit dodgy.
Come on, we, as the co-host, we have to have a lovely piece of Douglas's work. And without further ado, would you introduce your poem?
I can't really remember which poem I submitted, but we'll save that one for later.
Well, let's just call it Bottoms Up.
Oh, no, I've remembered now. It's called Gold, Silver, Brass and Steel, I think.
That's what I'll be like tomorrow morning, straight up. Douglas Wilson, yes.
Oxygen is life, but it cuts like a knife. And I will still go, even though I might breathe it tomorrow. But I will see you in 100 years, and I will see you through a tear. And yet I don't really know for how long, and I don't know why life turns the wrong way round and leaves my body in the ground. But you, do you come from within the water, or from just beside? Like a crystal vase in the autumn, a crystal vase beside my side. I saw you shining pure, I saw you waving, like a butterfly in the North Pole, or like solid earth pulsating. You are rare and you are strong, and yet I don't understand the words of your song. Like a distant whisper or a distant laugh, like pure crystal, just like pure glass. I don't want you to fade from me, or for that matter anybody. Come, let's run through fields of daisies, let's get covered by the grass, and let the pollen kiss us. If you go away, I may follow you until my final day. I might hunt you down around the earth, and if I find you, perhaps it'll be worth it. You seem pure to me, made clean and white, like the magic cleansing power of the night, like a child, like the rain, like the beauty of birth pain. Let's dance among dry tulip petals. Let's adorn our heads with nature's precious metals, gold and silver, brass and steel, and let us journey like a wheel round and round the earth and back to that place, the sacred plain. Let's sing a cosmic song. Let's suck in life good and strong. Do you know what? You are not cotton, and you are not denim. You're fine silk and pure white linen, edged with rubies and with song, honey kisses and soft green lawn.
I think he needs to work on his diction.
That's a new bohemian, Douglas Wilson of the poet. Dramatic Society of South Africa and London. Oh my God, darling.
Oh, thank you.
Like, I'm just so, as I said earlier, you know, you're writing your manuscript. You know, we're going to do more pieces about how to help writers go forward and have agents, publishers with a writer sort of life. A conversation which I really want to get you involved with.
Oh, thank you.
But I don my hat to you with all of your, you know, your progress, your work, and how much you've just come like a shooting star. So well done.
Thank you. And you know, being part of Celine Salon has really helped me improve and grow as a poet.
Yes.
As I said earlier, we need to expose ourselves and integrate ourselves within the creative community.
Yeah. Well, I think the most integral part for me is like platforming other people's work and giving people a stage to share their work, gain confidence. You've met great friends, so I don't mean to burp them.
Yeah, that's all right.
You know, it's also about other poets and writers becoming friends, which you have done. And we've got like a whole like
so
social,
dynamic.
It's so cool.
Yeah.
And I'm sorry to say, we're coming towards the end of our show. So I'm not going to say anything because I'm going to let Douglas do the work because the next writer-artiste is off.
Very exciting, Celine. If I can just pick up from where you've left off. We've got Mila Smith. Now, Mila Smith is just this up-and-coming recording artist in South Africa. She's only 17.
Wow.
She's just been signed to this amazing company, which is called Platoon, artist management company. She rose to fame very swiftly with a young band called the Skyscrapers.
Great.
And now she's gone solo
and
hot off the press. She's just released her new video on the 16th of April. And we have been lucky enough to get it into our little grips.
Thank you, Mila.
Mila Smith.
Thank you. Boom.
When I succeed, things go quiet and then you leave. Who you trying to be? Who you trying to be? Further and further, nobody catches me. They said stay strong, but I'm feeling weak. Longing for someone, someone to stand with me. But baby, can't you see? I don't like lying.
Oh, no! That brings us to the end of our show. Celine Salon collaborates with South Africa. And Douglas, thank you for being such a wonderful, wonderful host.
Oh, thank you so much for having me here.
I'm really looking forward to us co-hosting more.
Yeah.
And I'm going to hand it over to you to give a rundown of all the wonderful performers we've had.
Okay, okay. Tonight. Well, thank you so much, Celine.
That's all right, love.
If
you shove another 50 quid in there,
down the boobs, you know. But guys, thank you so much for your contributions. I hope that everyone has enjoyed this as much as we have. Yay. It's been an amazing creative process. So we've had Kate Normington, Christine Weir, Megan Choritz. Choritz, sorry, darling. Sydney Scallon, Godfrey Johnson. Lily Slapsilla, Shannon Faree,
Douglas Wilson,
and Mila Smith.
And you've had the wonderful host, Douglas Wilson, and yours truly, La Celine, or Celine Hispiche. Please, please, please leave comments. Please subscribe. Please share. Spread the word. And thank you to all of you who have come on tonight to support Douglas Wilson, South Africa, and Celine, UK, Celine Salon.
Thank you so much. Thank you for having me, Celine.
That's all right, love.
Love you, darling.
Right, you can do the washing up now. Mwah.
Shifting your paradigm. The lady on the scene, Celine Salon. Salon de Celine, the lady on the scene. You know what I mean? The lady on the scene, Celine Salon, Celine Salon, Celine Salon, Celine Salon, Celine Salon, the lady on the scene.